happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Have a happy Hanukkah. And welcome to A Christmas Card to You, a celebration of the differences of Christmas. This show is going to say that we have strength in our differences, that we are special because we are all very, very different. What we're going to do during the show is talk to some children and find out how each of them celebrates Christmas in their own home. We're going to look at some children who are decorating trees in Poland or in Ireland. We're going to talk to the auxiliary bishop of Chicago, and we're going to listen to a boys' choir in this, a Channel 5 Christmas card to you, this Christmas, Chicago style.
When a headache says take something strong, but common sense says take something safe, what should I take?
Look, six popular headache remedies. All are safe, used as directed. All but one are regular strength. Of all these, only one, Anacin, combines that safety with extra strength. Anacin's pain reliever is recognized safe by experts, used as directed.
Strength with safety. That's common sense.
Of all these, only one, Anacin, combines safety you expect with extra strength you want.
These are Diamonds Rogers sells. They're guaranteed. I'm Juell Kadet, Vice President of Rogers Jewelers. At Rogers, every diamond you purchase carries one of our famous guarantees. And during the first year, if for any reason whatsoever, you're not satisfied, Rogers will exchange your diamond for another of equal value. If I wasn't that sure of Rogers diamond jewelry, I wouldn't sell it.
Christmas is about Christmas trees. Christmas trees from around the world, and that's one of the celebrations that the Museum of Science and Industry have each year at this time, and it'll be going on through January 7th. And because of that, and because we want to find out what is Christmas like in various countries, we're going to have our own little mini Christmas around the world celebration. And first, we're going to find out from Trisha about Christmas in Ireland. Now, how is Christmas in Ireland different from Christmas in America?
Well, in Ireland, we don't have Christmas trees. We decorate the house with holly. And it grows wild in Ireland, so.
It does?
Mm-hmm.
And you bring it inside, and but there's no trees?
No, we decorate the windows with it, like we like put it around the window.
And there's something that you do in the window that's a little different, too.
We put a candle in the window to light the way for Jesus and Mary on Christmas Eve.
And you still do that in Chicago, too, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, do you have fire alarms, smoke detectors?
No.
You better get one. Now, you want to tell me, we have John here, too, and you want to tell us about a saint and something, a celebration about that that happens around Christmas time?
About St. Stephen's. Like, when Ireland was in war, they couldn't, England didn't want them to have a religion. So St. Stephen's would go around secretly and give masses in a house. And one day the soldiers came to the house where he was serving mass. Uh-huh. And so they hit him up on the thatched roof. And then a wren flew up there and started making noise. And so when the soldiers went up there and looked, they caught St. Stephen and shot him. And so now they celebrate St. Stephen's Day the day after Christmas. And the kids dress up like we do on Halloween. And they go to house from house to house. And they do some kind of entertainment, like singing, dancing, or playing an instrument.
Wait. The day after Christmas, the children of Ireland dress up like Darth Vader and.
No. Yeah, so like we do on Halloween.
Uh-huh.
And like they go and they entertain the people, and the people give them money, and they give all the money to the poor, the kids.
That sounds very nice. Now, what is that you've got in your hand, Trisha?
This is the hats they wear. On St. Stephen's Day.
This is the hats for the day after Christmas. Can you put them on, or is it too itchy? It's too itchy to put on?
They're kind of small.
I see. But those are the, hold them up a little bit. Those are the actual hats that would be worn on St. Stephen's Day.
Well, there are other ones. Like, some people just wear masks and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But This is a rush hat. It's made out of rushes.
I see. Well, thank you both very, very much. Now, through the miracle of television, only in Chicago, only in America, we go from Ireland to Poland. And tell me about the tree and the decorations on the tree. Who would like to lead off with that?
Grace. Decorations are homemade by the kids and the parents, and we make different kinds of decorations. We have a couple decorations, like the porcupine, and we'll show how to make that. We'll show how
the
to make
the porcupine.
Yes, it's called Jezik in Polish, but it's a porcupine.
And what is that? What is that made out of?
It's made out of paper, and you need paper. Tissue paper is better because this is very hard, and you need needle and thread, glue, toothpick, pencil, scissors, and you need a 15 for a small one. This is a large one, and 18 for a large one. And you roll it up on the paper, on the pencil, and take the glue and cover it. I'll demonstrate later.
No, well, we may not have time for a full demonstration,
well,
but what?
I'll just show you one.
Okay.
And then we have this one. It's like a star. We don't know the real name of it. It's called, I think, Gwiazdeczka Polna. I'm not sure. And then we have the little house here.
Let's see.
This is a little house. It's made out of paper and glitter, and other objects I've put in sometimes. And this is another colorful Jezik porcupine.
Yeah.
It's something like this one, but it's just different colors.
Mm-hmm.
We have little stars we make.
Mm-hmm.
And there's many different kinds, but we didn't.
Well, what I would like to do, I'm very partial to food, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about the food of Christmas, all right? First, tell me your name.
Nellie.
Okay, Nellie.
On Christmas, the dinner consists of 12 courses, meatless, of course, and it's usually pierogi and kapusta, sauerkraut, and Polish sausage, fish, all different kinds of pastries, homemade, of course, and
what I would like to find out about is opotek. What is that? And what opotek?
Opłatek.
Yeah. I'll get it right yet.
It's a Polish wafer, and people break it before dinner to wish each other, luck for the coming year, and, you know, they kiss each other after they break it, and it's real fun.
It's real fun?
Yeah.
You like being kissed on? What about Vigilia?
Vigilia.
Tell me about that.
That's the dinner they have in...
That's the dinner. What's after church?
We
go to church at 12 o'clock at night. We come home. Then next morning it's a vigilia. You have bread and all kinds of different kinds of meats. And it's basically like a regular meal, but we have 12 different kinds of courses. And after that we go to the Christmas tree. We sing, and then we. Give out our presents to who we want to.
Now, one second, I'm going to interrupt here. What about unmarried women? Tell me about unmarried women. Somebody told me there's something special that happens to unmarried. You did?
Yeah.
All right, tell me, Nellie, tell me about unmarried, being one yourself, I assume.
they have a contest. They start at the window, and they take off their shoes, and they take turns putting their shoes down, and the girl...
Down where? On the window?
On the floor. And they set it up so the first one that her shoe comes out the door, she gets married first. It's a tradition. You know, that they set it up one by one, you know, and the first one that her shoe goes out the door, they keep doing it until one of the shoes is out the door and she's going to get married first.
Nellie, thank you very, very much for telling us about some customs from Poland. What we're going to do now is take a little break. When we come back, some friends, some children will be talking about the differences of Christmas. Join us for a celebration of differences.
Hi, you want to see my gift from the Lung Association? It's
me, Lamb Chop.
What are you doing in that little box?
Good things come in small packages.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, what else is good and small?
Christmas seals.
What's good about them?
What's good about them?
What's good about them?
Is there an echo around here? Christmas seals is good because they make really good decorations on your holiday boxes and cards.
Sweetheart, what you have to say...
Oh, you think that just because you are the 1978 Christmas seal chairperson, you know all the good things to say.
Okay, you tell them. Christmas seals, but you have to say that for 72 years, Christmas seals have been protecting our lungs against disease and air pollution, both preventing and curing breathing ailments, all year long. And if folks will just answer their Christmas seal letter generously, you know, we'll all breathe easier. That's what you got to say.
I don't got to say all that.
Why not?
Because you just did.
Oh, yeah.
It's the season of high spirits and festive decorations. To enjoy it all, be certain your Christmas tree is beautiful and safe. If you buy a natural tree, make sure it's fresh. There should be no brittle branches, no shedding needles. Put your tree in a steady holder filled with water. And keep all trees, natural and artificial, away from heat sources. Check lights for frayed wires, loose connections, broken or cracked sockets. Always unplug tree lights before you go out or to bed. Never leave a lighted tree alone. Choose decorations with care, too. Make sure all your trimmings are non-combustible or flame-resistant. And be prepared to act fast should a fire emergency develop. Your local fire emergency number is on the inside front cover of the telephone directory. Keep it handy, near the phone. Then have a happy, safe holiday season.
And I'd like you to meet some friends of mine now. You know, we say that Christmas is best through the eyes of a child. Well, we're going to listen to some children and find out about the differences of Christmas. We're going to have a celebration of the differences of Christmas. And what we're going to do mainly is learn from the people that we normally teach. And so what I'd like to do now is I'd like all of you to think back to when you were young. I want you to remember back, think about it when you were young, and what was Christmas like? Does anybody have any memories of Christmas?
When I woke up on Christmas, I saw the toys.
Is there anything special or different about the way you celebrate Christmas in your home?
In Poland, we don't hang up stockings.
You don't?
No. See, in Poland, we have different food, and we celebrate it sort of in a different way.
Well, like, tell me about it.
Well, would you like to know what we eat?
Yes.
Okay. the first thing we do is prayer. We pray.
Mm-hmm.
And then we give a piece of a płatek that's wafer, like flat. It's sort of like paper, but isn't.
And special, that's a special Christmas wafer of some sort?
Yes.
And who do you give it to?
We give it out to the family. Like, everybody gets a piece of it. And we break off a little piece, and then we bless other people.
Tremendous. That's interesting. What was it like the first time that you visited Santa Claus, maybe, and sat on his lap and had, ooh?
Well, I went up to, I was really excited, and I asked him for a doll and a tricycle.
I saw him in the store where you get cards, and then he gave me a candy cane.
I'd never seen him before, and I was scared.
You were scared?
But then I went back to him, and I sat on his lap and said everything.
You said everything, and it came out all right? Jennifer, I wanted to find out from you. Now, you celebrate Hanukkah, right? Now, tell me about Hanukkah. What do you do for Hanukkah?
The first thing we do is, like, my mom or dad buys us some presents, and then they wrap them and hide them. And then we take out a menorah and put candles in it, then we light them, and then we sing a blessing, and then we go find our presents, and then we open them.
Joey, do you have something about Hanukkah, too?
Well, yeah. On the first day of Hanukkah, we light two candles. On the menorah, there are nine candles.
Uh-huh.
Four on each side and one in the middle. And first, you light the first one, and with that one, you light the first one on the first day. Then you light that one again and light the first one and the second one and the next day and so on and so forth. And usually our parents buys us some, you know, toys, and then they wrap them and then they bring them out, and sometimes we sing songs.
What do you think about all the beautiful decorations downtown? What are your favorites?
I like the lights on the Christmas tree in Chicago.
The Christmas tree has lots of, well, lights, like red lights, yellow lights, all different colors.
Does anybody remember a store window with all the things that moved and everything like that? Anybody like to describe that? Here's a gentleman who hasn't talked before. Tell me about store windows.
I remember a store window that all the store had a whole row of windows, and it was like a story of this Christmas carol in it.
With Scrooge and everything?
Yeah, with Scrooge, and then how mean he was.
Speaking of decorations, here's a girl in a costume. What nationality are you, and what are you holding in your hand? Is that a doll?
See, it's just like Santa Claus, but doesn't ring. But it isn't, because Santa Claus doesn't go to Italy.
Santa Claus doesn't go to Italy?
No.
Really?
Yeah.
So no. Who goes to Italy?
The Befana.
Befana, and that is the Befana? And what does the Befana do?
See, it gives candy to the good children, and it gives a piece of coal to the bad children.
Can you tell me, have you ever gotten a lump of coal?
No.
Ever? Never?
No.
Never? All right. No. Robin, do you do anything special that you enjoy at Christmas time?
I help decorate the tree. I have my stocking on the chimney, and we go to Mass, and I go to my relatives' houses and give them their presents, and they give them my presents.
I get a tie.
You got to tell me something? All right, what are you going to tell me?
We made stockings, and we put them up, and one day St. Nicholas came to our school, and he put stickers in our
suckers
in our stockings.
Really? Do you have a holiday wish, a wish for the world? If you could have anything happen in the world that you wanted, what would you wish for?
I wish that no one would starve and there were no wars.
I wish that nobody would fight.
I wish for that everybody would be kind to others.
I wish for a lot of toys.
I wish that everybody would be healthy and they would love each other.
I wish everyone would have peace in life.
What is it you like best at Christmas time?
I'm in a choir, and we sing at these homes for elderly people. And when we go there, like, they feel better, like after we sing.
We've heard some really beautiful children talk about their hopes and their prayers and their wishes on this holiday season. And we've seen that Christmas can be celebrated in different ways in different homes, and it's still okay because the child still loves it and participates in it. I suppose it's trite, but it's a wish, it's a prayer that the feeling of this holiday season could continue all year long. We're going to take a little break now, and then we'll come back with Bishop Alfred Abramowicz, Auxiliary Bishop of Chicago, and we'll also hear from the boys' choir of the Five Holy Martyrs Church.
Mm-hmm. the color in them. That's my favorite. All of these paintings were done by kids. And just like last year, the paintings have been turned into Christmas seals. And you know, when you use these Christmas seals on your holiday mail and gift packages, you're working with your lung association to help everyone with breathing problems.
Like getting people to quit smoking. And more people are quitting all the time.
And doing something about air pollution. The Lung Association says it's really improving in some places. That's great news.
And you know what's the greatest? You help the Lung Association keep all their programs going through the year because you use Christmas seals.
So do everything you can by using Christmas seals every way you can.
How about this?
Money.
Whether it's air pollution, smoking, asthma, or any breathing problem, your Lung Association cares about every breath you take.
They really do.
We're talking with Auxiliary Bishop of Chicago, Bishop Abramowicz. Welcome.
Thank you, Norman.
We're in a very interesting time in terms of the world. There is a Polish pope, and I'd like you to share your thoughts about him and what may be going through his mind right now.
Right now, I think, although he's Holy Father of all nations, of all peoples, he must, in a sense, be a lonely man. Mm-hmm. He's a foreigner in Rome, as Bishop of Rome. And he is away from his people. And although this is a season of joy, happiness, generosity, love for all, I'm sure he's experiencing that. But I think he's experiencing a certain amount of loneliness.
Kind of homesick for Poland at Christmas,
correct.
Sort of.
Homesick for home. Like I'm sure thousands are here in the States too, perhaps uh-huh. separated from their families for some reason or other. And I'm sure he's experiencing something like that.
Do you have any thoughts about the world and the state of the world today? Any wishes that you might present to us about the world as we face Christmas and then the new year?
I think as a man of faith, I see a divine intervention here. Even in the church, for the first time in 455 years, a foreigner is coming to be a bishop of Rome. Successor of St. Peter, vicar of Christ on earth. And that's bound to have a tremendous effect in world history and in church history.
Mm-hmm. Is there any wishes or prayers that you might have in terms of this holiday season, this somewhat unique holiday season?
Right. In Polish, we have a very beautiful saying. We have Wesołych Świąt Bożego Narodzenia, Szczęśliwego Nowego Roku, Pokój Rodzinie, duszy, światu I narodowi. It's a Merry Christmas and happiness to all, to your personal life and the family life and the life of our nation and peace and harmony in the whole world.
As Auxiliary Bishop, reflect for a moment on what is going on in the Polish community tonight. In a few minutes, they're going to see the Pope live. And reflect what might be going on in the minds of many Chicagoans of Polish descent.
Extreme joy, happiness. We Polish people and many of the Czechoslovakians, Ukrainians, have a beautiful custom of a desire to be united with our own. And we do it with a simple gesture of sharing bread, not fancy foods, but just plain, ordinary wafer. And as we break bread, we wish each other the best of everything that life can give to us.
And there's renewed spirit in the community in terms of the Pope, is there not?
Very much so, very much so. We're Americans, like you've seen in this program, children of every nation. Happily, Christmas coincides with Hanukkah, a union of all faiths, a pluralism of all beliefs. And we are united in the fact that we are one, we are Americans. And in the light of faith, we are all children of God. We're all brothers and sisters to one another. This is the joy and the true meaning of Christmas.
Now, one last thing. Say peace on earth, goodwill toward men in Polish for me.
Pokój wszystkim ludziom na świecie I pokój narodowi i całemu światu.
Something we both mean.
Yes.
We're now going to hear the boys' choir from the Five Holy Martyrs Church to sing some Christmas carols. Thank the choir of the Five Holy Martyrs Church, the children who were here. You know, Christmas really ought to be a celebration of differences. It's the differences that make us special and stronger. We aren't a nation of homogenized people. What we are a bunch of people who came from different countries and prove that some of the time, hopefully much of the time, we can get together. And so it's our very differences that make us stronger and special. And that is our Christmas card to you. I want to wish you, on behalf of myself and everyone here at Channel 5, a Merry Christmas, a Happy Hanukkah, season's greetings, and may the new year bring you peace, happiness, and health. Merry Christmas.
I'm Chuck Henry. Join me for a special program of stories that New Center 5 reporters will never forget. Chicago Reflection 78, Thursday night at 7 on Channel 5.
Harry, that's a lot of medicine.
It's his cold. I need something for sneezing, runny nose, and nasal congestion, aches, fever.
My Dristan's better.
Better?
You bet. Dristan's better because it relieves all those cold miseries all by itself. Neither Contact, Vicks Sinex, nor Bayer relieves all those cold symptoms, but Dristan does, all by itself.
Dristan is better.
Dristan tablets relieves all those cold miseries better than Contact, Bayer, or Vicks alone.
These homes on Prairie Avenue date back to the turn of the century. In some cities, urban renewal means tearing down old neighborhoods.